गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. इन लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ स्पोरोफाइट ऑफ मरकेंशिया एंड नाउ यू ऑल आर फैमिलियर विद दिस स्पोरोफिटिक स्ट्रक्चर. एंड एस वी ऑल नो स्पोरोफाइट हैज़ थ्री डिफरेंट रीजन्स, फोर्सीटा एंड कैप्सूल. सो नाउ द नेक्स्ट प्रोसेस विच हैज़ टू हैपन इज द डहिसेंस ऑफ स्पोर्स or the dehiscence of this capsule. Capsule has to rupture and it has to release the spores formed inside the capsule for further development, and the spore has to germinate. So this process, it happens by the elongation of ceta. The cells in the ceta region, they elongate, and this elongation, it causes this capsule, as this ceta region elongates, it causes the capsule region to be pushed downwards. So this pushing causes the rupture of the protective layers. We know that the capsule has three protective layers: calyptra, perigynium and perigaceum. So as the ceta elongates, it pushes this capsule layer to the downwards, and this pressure causes the protective layers to rupture. So the protective layers rupture, and then what happens is the capsule is surrounded by a single layered sterile jacket. So that sterile jacket layers, the cells in that jacket layers, they have annular thickenings, and this annular thickening ruptures, and this sterile layer is ruptured, causing the release of the spores and elaters to the outside. So these elaters, they cause a jerky motion. So this jerky motion is caused by the hygroscopic movement of this elaters. So this jerky movement of elaters, caused due to the hygroscopic action, causes the spores to be dispersed. So the spores which are seen in clusters, they will be dispersed uniformly to the outside. So now the spores are released outside, and these spores, they may be viable for around 1 year after the dehiscence. So within this 1 year, if they come to accomplish any favorable condition, then they start germinating. So when a favorable condition comes, these spores, they germinate by forming a division, and two daughter cells are formed, upper cell and lower cell. So the lower, smaller cell which is formed, it will again divide to form the rhizoidal part, and the upper larger cell which is formed, it again repeatedly divides to form a filamentous structure. That filamentous structure forms the shoot or the aerial part of the gametophyte or aerial part of the Merkantia thallus. So this filament, it has two cells at its apex, and one of the two cells, it will act as a apical cell that will repeatedly divide to form new cells. So by repeated division of these apical cell and likewise the rhizoidal cell, it will form the thallus. Both rhizoids and the aerial part is formed, thus an independent Merkantia gametophyte is formed. So this is how Merkantia completes its life cycle. Okay, now this Merkantia again goes through all these processes to complete the next life cycle. That is, it develops a male gametophyte and a female gametophyte. The tetrad spores are formed in tetrads, no? So in this tetrad, two of the spores, it will give rise to male thallus, and the other two spores, it will give rise to the female thallus. Thus male and female thallus are formed, and in this male and female thallus, they develop anthridiophores containing the anthridium, and likewise archegoniophore containing the archegonium respectively. And then in these structures, in these sex organs, they develop respective gametes, that is, egg and anthrozoids will be formed, and they cause fertilization through raindrops, splashing raindrops, and fertilization happens and sporophyte is formed. Then this sporophyte ruptures and dehisces the spores outside. This spore comes outside and under favorable conditions they germinate to form again the gametophyte. So the next generation is formed. So this cycle continues. This is how a life cycle of Merkantia is completed. So I hope you will be clear with this. Thank you.